we are talking about the foreign exchange market. This is the one of the important chapters in terms of international financial management and generally in the MBA space license paper. So myself, Professor Rajiv Sinha, and we are talking about the foreign exchange market. Now, I just understood forex market. For the common people, we can say the forex means the foreign exchange. Only convert one currency into another currency is called the foreign exchange. But for the traders, we are doing the export and import business and the in terms of balance of payment, forex means the market for the currency trading. Well, a lot of risk factors like the hedging, arbitrations, risk factors are involved there. Now, in terms of introduction of forex market, the foreign exchange market, also known as the FX market, or the foreign exchange market, known as the forex market, also is the largest, most traded financial market in the world. The FX market grew on the daily trade volume of over 5 trillion a day, dollar a day, in which the 200 times bigger than the New York Stock Exchange. You know that in New York Stock Exchange, nowadays one of the largest stock exchange in the world in terms of trade volumes, you can say that. Historically, the major players of the foreign exchange market were the largest central bank, multinational firms, and the big financial institutions. While these organizations are still the major players in the market, the growth of the online brokers and the technology have made the possible the individual retail traders to access the market and trade up the level playing field and the big players. Now, foreign exchange market. The foreign exchange market is the market in which the participants are able to buy, sell or exchange the exploit the currency also. So, foreign exchange market made of the bank, commercial company, central bank, investment management firms, hedge fund and the retail forex brokers and investors here. The forex market is considered the largest financial market in the world. Foreign exchange market. The foreign exchange market, also called the forex market, currency market, trade to currency, is at the providing the flow of buying, selling and exchanging exploration currency. The forex also called enables conversion of the international trade and the investment. The forex market has a unique characteristic by property that an attractive market for investors who want to optimize their profit by selling and buying and selling the foreign currency. In terms of we are taking the some of the big players in terms of foreign exchange market, and we are taking the certain banks and financial institutions we have taken here. And so bank and the shares of the foreign market or shares of the forex market in the Citibank, basically from America, and they are having the 16.11%. Deutsche Bank from Germany, the 14.54%. Barclay from the Britain, 8.11%. JP Morgan Chase, 7.65%. UBS, 7.30%. Bank of America, this is the 6.22%. Then HSBC, Bank Hong Kong and Shanghai Banking Corporation, head office of London, is the 5.40%. BNP Paribas from France is the 3.65%, and Goldman Sachs is the 3.40%. RBS is the 3.38%, Associated General is the 2.43%, and the Standard Chartered Bank is the 2.40%. So these are the certain big players in terms of banking sector, financial institutions we have taken, and their foreign exchange shares in the forex market. Now, nature of the forex market. So one thing is the perfect competitions are there. Many buyers and sellers are there, and the highly quality information, because the it is regulated by all over the world, and the central government they are involved, and the to regulate such market. So highly quality informations are there. Seeking the best price, you will get the, because the organized platform are there, so you will get the best price there. Only one market is there, the forex market, and homogeneous outputs are there in the similar nature product you are. So largest forex trading currency in the world. So forex market trading is truly the global phenomena, as well as the largest financial market in the world, over the $4 trillion changing hand in the daily basis. Looking at the most recent Bank of International Settlement foreign exchange report published every 3 years, we get the clear view where the most of the daily forex trading volume take place. Many of the usual suspects like the UK and USA are the on the top list of the largest forex trading centers, while the others such as the Singapore may be the most surprising to many. We are the list of the some of the largest forest trading centers in the world. Right, first in we take in the United Kingdom, the UK and the and its financial center of the London participate in the largest percentage of all global forest daily trading volume in any geographical locations. UK daily trading volume increased from 35% in the 2007s and total 37% in the world overall the trading volume in 2010s according to the BIS data. Total daily trading volume rose by 25% in 2007 when the dollars volume equated 1483 billion to the 2010 when the volume stood 1854 billion per day. The more recent report is shown that daily volume just passed 200 billion March and April 2011. We have taken some past data. Financial capital London average daily trading volume with the almost we taken the data of 2010, so 1854 billion dollar and the percentage daily forest volume is 37%. Second, the United States. So the United States come to the second of daily trade volumes and the largest country of the list over the 300 million people. The US amounted to total the 18% daily trade of global forest trade volume in the 2010, following the 17% share in the volume 2007. So total dollar amount trade increased by 20% in the 904 billions a day in 2010 from the total of 745 billions in 2007. Financial capital, New York City, you can say that average daily trading volume the 904 billions dollar and the percent daily global forest volume is the 18%. Now Japan. Japan is the third largest forest trading centers with an with a total of 6% of global foreign exchange turnover take place in this country in 128 million people. Japan also amounted 6% of global turnover in 2007 following the 8% shares in 2004. Total amount of the trading surged by the 20% from $250 billion dollar in 2007 total of $312 billion dollar in 2010. Financial capital is the Tokyo and the average daily trading volume the $312 billion dollar and percent daily global forest volume the 6%. Now in terms of foreign exchange trade process, we are talking about the some of the basic terminology here, like the base currency. So just understood base currency, one national home currency or national currency, base currency, quota currency in which you wish to convert the any international currency, exchange rate, the rate at which the one currency converted into another currency, long position, it's a in the buying nature, buying if you are dealing with the buying the foreign currency for the long positions, short position in terms of selling the foreign currency, and or long position in terms of if you say the price will increase in coming future, so on that condition it is called long position also. Bid price and ask price. Bid price, the rate at which the bank purchased the foreign currency from the customer. And ask price, the rate at which bank sell the foreign currency to the customer. And spread, the difference between the ask price and the bid price is called the spread. Spread generally we are talking in terms of percentage only. Now there are certain some factors are there that affect the foreign exchange rate. So just understood. Like first is the inflation, the rate inflation, you can say that where the price will increase, there's an increase in the price, but as similar to that our purchasing priority not changes, not increasing on that way. So it is called the inflations, then interest rate in terms of loan, you can say that public debt and the political stability, the stability in political stability not there in the country, on that condition also affect the foreign exchange rate and the economic performance, like the GDP and the GNP growth rate, and terms of trade and the current account deficit also when the your import is more than export. These are the certain things that affect the foreign exchange rate. The foreign exchange trading process, if you are talking about the foreign exchange trading process, the foreign exchange trading the contract between two parties. These are the three types of trades, that is spot market is the then we are talking about the spot market. The spot market currency price at the time of trade. Suppose that at any point of time we convert the Indian national rupee in terms of dollars, so it is called the spot market. So forward market, we are not dealing today, we are dealing any day after today, like the after 1 month, 2 months, 6 months or any time. But we are do the agreement today, so it is called the forward market, but outside the stock exchange. So forward market agreement to exchange currency to agree upon the price the future date. The swap trade involved in the both. Dealers buy a currency at today price on the spot market and sell the same amount in the forward market when the price will rise. On the and the they can get the profit this way. They can just limit the risk in the futures also, no matter how much the currency falls, and they will not lose more than the forward price. So exchange determination in the spot market. The foreign exchange market among the largest market in the world with an annual trading volume of the excess $160 trillion nowadays. It is it is the over the counter market where no central trading locations, no set hour is trading is there. Price of the other trade of the trade determined by the computerized negotiation. So there are three market in the foreign exchange. One is called the spot market. Today at any point of time we convert the our home currency into international in terms of dollars. So deal with the currency with the immediate delivery within 1 or 2 business days is called the spot market. Future market involved in the futures but outside the stock exchange, like with any agency or the we can say the bank we are dealing, and for the for 1 month period, 2 months, 6 months from today, delivery the foreign currency. Currency futures or the option market deal with the contract to hedge against future change in the foreign exchange rate. Now hedge is again Tom Jandi, we are using the currency convertibility in the forward market or the future market Jandi to minimize the risk factor involved in the convertible currency in future date. So this is called the hedge Tom Jandi we are using here. So meaning of the foreign exchange rate, the foreign exchange rate refers to rate at which the one unit of currency of a country can be exchanged with the number of units of the currency in the currency. So suppose that $1, for example, we are taking the rupees 67. So rupees 1 equal to 1 by 67 and $1 equal to 100 cent on that country, rupees 1 equal to 100 by 67. So you can say the 1.4925 cent. So exchange rate expressed in the ratio of exchange between the currency of one country. Now two terms we are using direct and indirect code. So direct code give the home currency price of a certain amount of foreign currency. Like we have written this, for example, we have taken the rupees 67 per US dollar. It means for getting one US dollar, we have to pay the rupees 67. Now in the indirect quote, the value of the one currency, home currency, in present in terms of foreign currency. Suppose that Bank of India will quote the exchange rate of US dollar 0.1014925 per rupee. So in 1 rupee against the 1 rupee, we have to pay the we will get the 0.014525. Like one question we are taking here, if the direct quote is given rupees 70 per US dollar, for example, we have taken how can this exchange rate can be presented under the indirect quote. So simply we have written the 1 US dollar equal to rupees 70, so 1 rupee equal to so you will get the US dollar 0.0142857 per rupee. So if indirect quote is the rupees US dollar 0.025 per rupee, how can this exchange rate can be shown on the indirect quote? So rupees 1 is given US dollar 0.025. So in terms of direct quote, you will write the rupees 40 per US dollar. Now we are coming to the buying and selling rate. So buying rate is the rate at which the bank purchases the foreign currency from the customer. So buying rate is the rate at which the bank purchases the foreign currency from the customer. So always bank is important here, where bank are purchasing or bank is selling. So bank is buying here. So rate at which the bank purchases the foreign currency from the customer. Suppose that one visitor comes from the European country and visited India. On that condition, he has to convert euro in terms of Indian national rupees. So he moved to the bank and just convert the euro in terms of rupee. So definitely bank will buy the euro and gives the Indian national rupee. So this kind of things when bank are doing, you call the buying rate or the bid rate, you can say that. So buying rate is also known as the bid rate. The selling rate, the rate at which the bank sell the foreign currency to customer. But one in Indian Indian we just move to the suppose that of Europe on the or the France and just convert Indian national rupee in terms of euro. So on that condition, bank will sell the foreign currency to the customer. So selling rate also known as the ask rate or the offer rate. And difference between the these two ask rate and the bid rate is called the bank profit, is called the spread. And spread always you calculate in terms of percentage. So if you write, for example, we are taking the rupees 40.30 per US dollar. So in the foreign exchange we will see this kind of quotation there. So it's always written in terms of bid, bid and ask. Bid here, first bid, then ask per US dollar. So 40 is the bid here and the 40.30 is the ask here. So it is in the rupees 40.30 per US dollar. Now buying and selling rate. So spread is this is the formula when we find out the spread in terms of percentage. So spread is the ask price minus bid price upon ask price into 100. So in the previous questions, if you are taking the example of the previous question, spread is here the ask price is the 40.30 and the bid price is the 40. So 40.30 minus 40 upon 40.30 into 100. So we will get the 0.744%. So consider the following bid ask price. If rupees 40.50 per US dollar, find the bid ask price. Using the same formula, you can get the answer 1.323%. And find out the bid rate if the ask rate are 40.50 per US dollar and the bid ask spread 1.30 rupees 40. So in this formula where spread equal to ask price minus bid price upon ask price into 100. So three variables are there, spread, ask price and bid price, and anything you have, that you have to find out here. Now balance of trade. We are coming to the balance of trade. It shows the visual trade transactions with the rest of the world. So in terms of visual items, in terms of tangible items, you can say the visual items, if you are dealing, it is called the balance of trade. It refers to the difference of the value of export and the imports of the goods. Import and exports. So balance of trade equal VX minus VM. So VX is the values of the value of the good export and VM is the value of good imported. The balance of trade difference between the you can see the value of the country import and export for a given period of time. Generally we are taking one financial year. So balance of trade is largest component of the country balance of payments. So balance of trade is the part of the balance of payment. In the balance of payment, we are taking the visual item, invisible item, current and the capital transfer also, and unilateral trade, these kind of things we are taking inside the balance of payment. The balance of trade also refer to the trade balance or the international trade balance. So type of balance of trade, favorable balance of trade where the value of export is more than value of import, and favorable balance of trade where the value of export is less than value of import, and the equilibrium when the export equal to import. So type of balance of trade, favorable balance of trade, so when the export is more than import, it is called the surplus in the balance of trade. And favorable balance of trade, when the import is more than export, we call the deficit in balance of trade. And equilibrium, when the both the export and import are equals. So if you're talking the difference between the balance of trade and balance of payment, so balance of trade refers to the difference between the amount export and import in the visible items only, you can say that. And balance of payment is the accounting statement. Balance of trade is the accounting statement that provides the systematic record of all the economic transactions between residents of a country and rest of the world. Balance of trade include only the visible items, but the balance of payment include the visible item, invisible item, unilateral transfer and the capital transfer also. Balance of trade does not record any transaction of the capital nature, but balance of payment record all the transactions in the capital nature. In the balance of trade, it narrow concept is only a part of the balance of payment, and it is the wider concept and they include balance of trade. In the balance of trade, unfavorable balance of trade can meet out the favorable balance of payment, and unfavorable balance of payment cannot meet favorable balance of trade. So these are some basic difference between the balance of trade and the balance of payment. Then a difference between the again we take some more difference, like the nature of transactions. So transaction concerned goods only with trade of goods only are recorded. In the balance of payment, all transaction concerned goods, service and capital transfer are recorded. In the capital transaction, transaction of capital nature not included in the balance of trade, transfer capital nature also recorded in the balance of payment. Mutual relations, balance of trade is a part of the current account or the balance of payment. But balance of payment is much larger, it is a current and capital account which include balance of payment also. Favorable balance of trade or balance of payment, when export of good is higher than the import, balance of trade is considered favorable. When net balance of the current account, capital account is a plus, balance of payment is considered favorable. Then we are talking about the currency convertibility. Currency convertibility is the base, is the age which, with which a country currency can be converted into gold or the another currency. When accuracy is in convertibles, it poses the risks and the barriers of trade and the foreigners, which are no foreigners which have no need for the domestic currency. Now, meaning of the currency convertibility. By convertibility of the currency, we mean currency of a country can be freely converted into foreign exchange. When suppose the Indian national rupee converted in terms of dollars at market determined rate of exchange, at the rate of exchange determined by the foreign exchange market and the exchange rate determined by the demand and supply of the currency, depend upon the demand and supply of the currency. For example, convertibility of the rupee means those who have foreign exchange like US dollar, pound and sterling. Now sterling now converted in terms of euro, you can say that can get them converted into rupees and the vice versa at a market determined range of the exchange. Under convertibility of the currency, they are authorized and dealers in the foreign exchange will consider the foreign exchange market. So current account and the capital account convertibility of currency. A currency may be convertibility of the or the current account. That is export or import of the merchandise of the individual items only. A currency may be convertibility on the both current and the capital accounts. So by capital account currently we mean that there is respect of capital flow, that is the flow of portfolio capital, that investment flow, flow of the borrowed fund and the dividend and the interest payables on them. A currency is freely converted into foreign exchange and vice versa at the market determined exchange rate. Now we are coming to the forward market. The forward market is informal, or it is called the over the counter market, outside the stock exchange dealing with any agency of the bank, to minimize the risk factor involved in the future convertibility of the currency. So forward market in formal over the counter market, financial market by which the contract or the future delivery are entered into. And standardized a forward contract is called the future contract or traded a future exchange. So future contract always we are dealing with the during the contract inside the stock exchange. It should not be confused with the future market. Future contract are traded in the stock exchange. Future contract always traded in the stock exchange where the forward contract traded over the counter outside the stock exchange. Suppose that any bank we are dealing that one. The forward market is highly customized. Each party has to deal with the counterparty risks. In the forward market always the counterparty risk factors are there. But in the exchange traded future market, there the contract are innovated because the like the RBI and the government rules are there or the international rules. It is regulated by the central government. Forward market quotations. So in the quoting rate may be expressed the outright quote for the swap quote. The outright quote is the US dollar in the in terms of rupees can be written the written for the different period for the forward contract as follow. In the spot market, in the forward market we have written the spot market 1 month and the 3 months. Spot price we have written the rupees 40-40.30. So if the bid asks buying price the rupees 40 and the selling price is the rupees 40.30 after 1 month, if you are dealing after 1 month, so it is the bid price is the 39.80 and the ask price is the 40.20. if you are dealing after 3 months, then it is it is dealing the 39.60 and 40.10. So just understood, in the spot market difference is 0.3, after 1 month difference is 0.4, and the after 3 months difference is 0.50. The swap quote on the other hand express, when the we are talking the swap quote on the other hand express only the difference between the spot quote and the forward quote. स्पॉट कॉट इज गिवेन 40.40-30, सो इट मीन द 40.30 आफ्टर वन मंथ इज द 20 and 10. सो इन द स्पॉट लाइक द 40 minus 0.20, सो इज द 39.20 एंड द 40.30 minus 10 इज द 40.20 आफ्टर 3 months 40 minus 0.40, सो 39.60 एंड 40.30 minus 20 इज द 40.10. ऑन दैट वे वी कैन अंडरस्टूड द what the informations are given the foreign exchange wings where we have to convert the Indian national rupee into in terms of dollar. So forward premium and discount in the above quoted you find the longer the maturity the greater the change in the forward rate. Again with a longer maturity the spread is too wide. This is because the uncertainty in the futures are there that increase the lengthiness of the maturity. The change in the forward rate may be upward and downwards. Such a movement disparity arises between spot and the forward rate. So future price can be more or less depends upon the disparity arise between the spot and forward rate. This is the known as swap and this is called the forward rate swap or the forward rate difference here. Let the forward rate if the future price forward rate is the less than spot rate, we call the forward discount. Or the forward rate more than today's rate, spot rate, it is called the forward premium. So these two important terms we are using here. If the forward rate is less than spot rate, suppose 1 month rate is less than today's rate, also forward rate is less than spot rate, so it is called the forward discount. And if the forward rate is more than spot rate, it is called the forward premium. Now swap. Swap is derivative in which the two counter party exchange cash flow or the partly financial instruments. For those party financial instruments, the benefit of question depend on type of financial instruments involved here. For example, in case of swap involve two bonds, benefit of the question can be periodic interest coupon payment assured with the such bond. Especially two counterparty agree to exchange one stream of cash flow against another stream. These streams are called the legs of the swaps. The swap agreement define the date which the cash flow can be paid and the way and they can acquire the calculated. Usually at a time when the contract initiated at least one of these series cash flow determined by the uncertain the variables such as the floating interest rate, foreign exchange rate, equity price or the commodity price. Now forward premium and discounts. So forward premium or the forward discount expressed as the annualized percentage deviation from the spot price. So forward premium or discount. Premium means the spot forward price is more than your spot price. The forward premium and forward discount mean the spot price is more than the your forward price. So and a forward rate. Suppose we taken 1 month. So in terms of number of days, 30 years. 1 month we are taken 30 days. Minus spot rate divided by spot rate in 360/N. Because we are taken 1 month 30 days, so in the 12 month 360 days, so 360/N, where n is the length of the forward contract is in the numbers of day. For example, we have taken here the end day forward rate is 39.80, and in the previous question we have taken the spot rate and the forward rate. 1 month forward rate is the 39.80, so 39.80 minus 40 upon 40 into 360/30, so we are getting minus 0.06% forward discount. So if the minus we are getting, so it's the forward discount here. So exchange rate determination, spot market, foreign exchange market, among the largest market of the world that we discussed. Three type of markets are there: spot market, forward market and the currency future option market here. And exchange determination spot market, that exchange rate between two currency of floating rate regime, the determination interplay the demand and supply force. The exchange rate between say the rupees and the US dollar depends upon the demand of the US dollar and the ability to supply the Indian foreign exchange market. The supply of the foreign exchange results in the receipt of the foreign currency, normally in account export or sale of the financial security, the foreign trade.